Dear viewers, I hope you are all fine. Stay safe, stay home during pandemic corona. Today I am here to introduce myself in front of you. It's my new YouTube channel. It is my first video. Hope you support me and like, subscribe and share it. From our channel, to teach about the pharmacognosy and phytochemistry, herbal cosmetics and herbal drug technology and natural medicine. Our explanation entirely based on the PCA syllabus for the pharmacy students. Our first topic is introduction of plant anatomy and physiology. This video is especially for pharmacy students, those who are all studying pharmacognosy and remedial biology. Plant is made up of different parts, mainly leaves, stem and root. Leaves collect energy from sun and make a food for plant using photosynthesis. Stem support the plant above the ground and carries the water and mineral to the leaves. Roots are responsible for transferring the necessary nutrients to the plant. Plant tissues are classified into epidermal or dermal tissues, vascular tissues and ground tissues. The ground tissues consist of parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Vascular system consists of xylem and phloem. Dermal tissues is consist of stromata and trichomes. Parenchymas are made up of thin cell walls and its main functions are photosynthesis and storage of the starch. Colenchymas are made up of uneven cell walls and gives rigid support to the plant. Sclerenchymas are made up of thick cell walls and give strength and support to the plant. Vascular tissues are two types. One is xylem, another one is phloem. Xylem transports the water and minerals from the root to leaves. Phloem transports the nutrients from the leaves to roots. Xylem vessels are one way only because it transports the water mineral from the root to different parts of the plant. But phloem two way flow because the food and water flow from all the parts of the plant. Xylem consists of vessel elements and xylem tracheids. When the phloem consists of sieve tubes and companion cells. This is a types of xylem and phloem. Now we are showing the pitted wall xylem as well as tracheid type of xylem. Xylem types: annular vessel, spiral vessel, scalariform vessel and reticulate vessel. Now we are showing the phloem structures by the means of companion cells and sheath plates. Now we are representing diagrammatic representation of xylem and phloem. This shows the tracheids, vessel elements, sheath tubes and sieve tube elements. Leaf anatomy. Leaf anatomy consists of upper epidermis, palisade parenchyma, spongy parenchyma and lower epidermis. The upper epidermis and lower epidermis, both the surface consist of cuticle. It is a protective layer. And centrally, it consists of vascular bundle, is made up of xylem and phloem. Transverse section of monocot leaf. From this leaf, both epidermal cells contain stromata, a thick cuticle present in both epidermis. Upper epidermis are larger in size. They are called pulliform or motor cell. Mesophylls are arranged compactly. The vascular bundles are closely arranged and surrounded by bundle sheath. PS of dicot leaves. The cuticle on the upper epidermis is thicker than lower surface. One layer of elongated cylindrical cells, they are called palisade parenchyma. The spongy parenchymas are loosely arranged. The vascular bundle is surrounded by compact layer of thin-walled parenchymatous cells. Transverse section of monocot contains thick cuticle, single layer epidermis, and epidermal hairs are absent. The ground tissues are not differentiated into cortex and pith. Hypodermis is generally sclerenchymatous. It has no distinct endodermis and pericycle. Epidermis contains stromata and God cells. The scattered vascular bundles are surrounded by sclerenchymatal bundle sheath. Each vascular bundle is oval, collateral, and closed structure. Transverse section of dicot stem. Single layer of parenchymatous cells are arranged compactly without intracellular space. The cortex region contains parenchyma, endodermis, vascular bundle, collenchyma, and pith. Hypodermis is made up of few layers of collenchymatous cells and give mechanical support. Endodermis are barrel-shaped, closely fitted cells and contain starch grains. It is called starch sheath. Vascular bundles are placed towards the epidermis than towards the center. The pith is a largest portion of the stem. It made up of colorless, thin-walled parenchymatous with a lot of intracellular space. Transverse section of monocot root. The outermost layer of parenchymatous cells without intracellular space. The stromata and cuticles are absent. Root hairs are single-celled. The cortex contains oval and rounded, loosely arranged parenchymatous cell. Endodermis is made up of single-celled, barrel-shaped parenchymatous cells. Vascular tissues are radially arranged. Xylem and phloem are separated by sclerenchymatous conjunctive tissues. The large portion is occupied by pith. The pith consists of abundant starch grains. Transverse section of dicot root. Epidermal cells are not cutinized. Epidermal cells are contained long hairy body, typically unicellular trichomes. The cortex is made up of thin-walled parenchymatous cells with chloroplast. It converts sugar into starch grains. The last layer of the cortex is endodermis. The vascular bundles are radial in roots. The xylem and phloem are separated by conjunctive tissues. The pith is absent in dicot root system. Thank you for watching this video. For regular class update in pharmacognosy, subscribe our channel. Thank you.